Okay, let's see the next question, number seven. Jaden conducted a paper race with two pieces of paper by dropping them from a given height. One piece of paper was flat, the other is crumpled. Okay. So this table shows the time taken. So this one is for the flat one. It takes a longer time compared to the crumpled one. So state the forces, I think not more than one, acting on a crumpled. So there are two forces. One is gravitational force and the other is air resistance or frictional force. Okay, so there are two forces. So number one is the frictional force, half mark, or air resistance. Second one is gravitational force, another half mark. Okay. So now the next question they ask, why did the crumpled paper reach the ground first in all three of these tries? Can you see the time is shorter, right? So the answer is quite straightforward because you say the crumpled ball of paper has less, this is a keyword, less surface area in contact or less contact area, less surface area in contact with the air than the flat sheet of paper, you must compare, than the flat sheet of paper, resulting in less frictional force acting between the crumpled paper ball and air. Okay, because it's a smaller surface area, right? So that means there's less air resistance. So less air resistance means it can come down faster. Okay, less air resistance. So it can come down faster. Okay, so this is quite straightforward. Okay, I will show you to end this class, to show you about less air resistance in a very exciting video clip shortly. So you complete this first. Okay, to end the class, I would like to show you how the surface area, right, will affect the speed of falling. Okay, because you know in parachuting, right, if you don't open the parachute, if you assume a steep dive, the parachutist will dive down at very high speed, maybe up to 200-300 kilometers per hour compared to this position. So this position, because air resistance acting this way, but if the parachute assume this position, right, so it's more aerodynamic, so we will dive down. So I do a screen share for you to understand the physics behind this scene here, over here. Sit back and relax.
Altitude 25,000 feet.
You see, he's diving in down, head down position. So this position will allow you to accelerate faster because there's less exposed survey area this way than this way. So replay a bit on this part.
Altitude 25,000 feet.
Diving into
Walker, what's the matter, Hunt? Afraid of a little lightning?
Okay, he spread out his arms, so decrease the speed of fall. Because apparently during the moment earlier, one of his the body was kind of being shocked by the lightning. Not the lightning strike him, but the lightning exploded near him.
20,000 feet.
You notice he can flip around and see, right? Because the air resistance is acting on his back. Okay, he's looking for where is his missing partner.
Do you copy? Walker.
You notice his partner is down here. It's like, I think he's unconscious. So later you observe this actor, Tom Cruise, is going to move forward to this part, but he's still falling down at a high speed.
Walker!
Okay,
10,000 feet.
Walker! 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 Walker!
Altitude, 10,000 feet. 9,000. 8,000. 7,000. 6,000. 5,000. 4,000.
Walker! Walker!
3,000. Deploy.
3,000 is about 3,000 feet is about 1,000 meters. So you see when his friend parachute open, he slows down a lot. But Tom Cruise is still falling down at a high speed.
Deploy.
Okay, the parachute open, you just look at this part. So this person will be dragged upwards. While this person, his parachute haven't opened, he will still fall down at a high speed.
Deploy.
Okay, before that, before he hit, he opened his parachute just in time. And the parachute gets stuck in the spire of this building. So safe landing for him. Just in time.
Oh god.
So that is this part about how the surface area affect the spore. So if the surface area is big, the timing for it to drop down is greater than this, than crumpet. Okay, so I've gone through this already. What you need to do is the remaining parts, if you can finish as homework. So you do question eight. Okay, question eight, question nine, and question 10. Okay. You do as homework too. Next week, I'll review the answer with you. Okay, these three questions. So, okay, everyone. By the way, today is the first NE show. Your friend going for the NE show. So later, you will take note, you can, about 6:45, some fighter jets will fly across Singapore. Okay, not the Blackbird. I'm wearing this Blackbird. This Blackbird is actually the fastest jet in the world, flying at Mach 3. But has been decommissioned by the United States because it's too expensive to maintain. So later y'all can see the fighter jets flying across Singapore about 6:45 because today is the first NE show. Okay, so I've ended my class today. You got any questions, you can ask me.